Dave Stewart has been one of the key parts. Acquired from Philadelphia in late May, Stewart has been used mostly as a starter in recent weeks because of injuries, and he's won four straight starts.
Tom Lawless, too.
You betcha. Three steals in the game for Toronto. And Bell misses that one.
Gaetti and Puckett. Reardon hacking it up. The pen.
2-2 pitch. Struck him out to end the inning. And just consider the Mets of 1986. They won 108.
They're just starting it tonight. There'll be 12 games on this trip. Hayes struck him out. Just power pitching right there. Manny Lee, strikeout number 7 for Stu.
They've got 9 strikeouts, season high for him in his last start last Sunday. This one, it's a good old fastball outside. The fact that Dave has limited his pitches in the first 6 innings going to make him as strong, if not stronger, the last 3.
Struck him out. 1 out in the 7th. Ray, let me ask you this. You caught no hitters. In fact, he caught one Dennis Eckersley pitched in Cleveland. The pressure comes now the rest of the way in a no-hitter in pitch selection like it doesn't come at any other time in a game.
It's not as if the count is in Olerud's favor. He is down 1-2.
He struck him out with a fork ball. 2 down in the 8th inning of the no-hitter.
That's a pitch that he knew he could come back with, and he took something off the fork ball. They fastballs, and then here comes the fork ball down in the dirt.
After those 2 walks, nobody has been on base. He has retired 24 in a row. Swing and a miss, number 25, and he is 1 out away. That's 4 strikeouts in a row and 12 in the ball game.
Look at the target up. See where Steinbach's holding it right even with the mask, and Stewart trying to go out in style.
Fly ball center field. Dave Henderson makes the call. A no-hitter for Dave Stewart. Dave Stewart has thrown a no-hitter, allowing only 3 base runners and 1 point retired 25 in a row. He was just in complete control and dominated Toronto.
He dominated all night, picking up his 10th win and even a little messing around with the mound that John Snooty did to try to pack up the rubber area didn't affect Dave Stewart tonight.
A no-hitter for Stewart. We will be back.
Outfield shaded around to the left for Boggs. Swings and misses, and he strikes out in a 1-2-3 inning. Stewart chalks up a strikeout. Red Sox leading. Here's the 3-2 pitch to Boggs. He's out of there. A called 3rd strike. Just where that 2nd strike was, right above the knees on the outside corner, and Stewart has his 3rd strikeout.
Right on the edge. Look at that stare.
Built more like a football player than a baseball player.
That's an example.
That's how strong he is, folks.
Holy cow. What is going on here?
Have you ever seen that before?
No.
I never have.
What is going on here?
I have never seen that before. He swung and missed and broke the bat.
We kiddingly talk about it. He's built more like Fort Bragg's. Now look at this. It hits his bat back and breaks in 2.
Did it when he hit his back.
Yeah, you've seen Bo Jackson do that over his head, over his knee. How about his back? We've never seen Bo do that. Maybe Bo doesn't know. Oh, my gosh. Oh.
One thing the A's have not done is given Dave Stewart much breathing room. One run only. There's a strikeout. Stewart's 1st of the night. He's retired 4 in a row.
One of the few splitters that he has thrown.
Thompson. Mitchell's wrist, and Robbie Thompson gone on strikes. Here's the split forkball. Your preference, and down goes Thompson.
Well, they call it a forkball in Oakland, split finger fastball in San Francisco. I tell you, 18 miles apart, pitch still does the difference.
Only about 75 people turn their original ticket stubs in. And Mitchell has gone on strikes. And so Dave Stewart picking right up where he left off a week ago Saturday has retired the 1st 4, and he has struck out 3 in a row.
A power hitter, power pitcher.
His 2-2 pitch coming to Mazzilli. Got him looking. Third strikeout for Stewart.
Stewart was ahead of Carter, two strikes, and now here's the 3-2 to him. That is the fifth strikeout of the game for Dave Stewart, and there's one gone here in the eighth inning.
Appears to have a pretty good fork ball today. And it looked like it might be it right there. Even on a 3-2 pitch with a comfortable lead, he gets Carter to chase it out of the zone.
Borders with the lead at first. Swing and a miss, strike three. And the fastball gets Lee, and that's a big first out.
All the great ones usually have that ability to make the big pitches to get out of jams to avoid the big inning. And that's been a trait of Dave Stewart for the last 5 years here in Oakland and winning, helping this team win championships.
Six runs have been unearned by the A's. Ground ball hit to Blankenship. This should do it. The ball game is over. And the A's win at home and extend the series as Dave Stewart goes the distance. The final score is 6-2.
But the Giants have certainly not made life easy for them tonight. It's a ground ball to the right side, speared by Phillips, flips to Eckersley. Yes, he's there in time, and the A's are the world champions.
And we found him, and he's here, and Ron's going to make the presentation.
Abe, on behalf of Chevrolet and the 5,000 Chevrolet Geo dealers, we're very happy to present this most valuable player trophy to you. In addition, Chevrolet will give to your favorite charity or civic organization a brand new Chevrolet Astro van. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. All I can say is we had 24 MVPs in this game, and I was just fortunate that I was chosen the main name in it. But you know, everybody contributed in us winning this thing, and this one is for Oakland, and this one is for all the mishaps that have happened in this to make it a thrill. The earthquake set us back a little bit, but you know, like I said before the series, even if we should happen to win or the Giants should happen to win, everybody in the area comes out a winner, and thank you very much.